As one would expect, they have dozens of banana recipes here at Iho Resorts. But I figure adding another one of mine certainly couldn't hurt.
Okay, so for dessert, I want to do banana bread pancakes and flavor that with some yogurt, cheese, and a little bit of cocoa syrup. The moment I bit into that jambok, it reminded me of banana bread, you know, just the full flavor of the bananas. And since I don't make banana bread, I figured I'll make pancakes instead. Our bananas are ready. We're gonna do the dry ingredients first for the pancakes. We're gonna need about 2 cups of all-purpose flour. For every cup of flour, you wanna add in 1 teaspoon of baking powder. This will help us keep it fluffy. I'm not gonna use any eggs, so it's not gonna be as fluffy as a normal pancake, but the baking powder will help.
I add in 1/4 cup of brown sugar to help get that banana bread color. Some salt to bring out the flavors. And cinnamon to complement the banana.
And now we can add in our wet ingredients. So of course the banana counts as a wet ingredient. So we'll just pour that in. I'm also gonna add in our melted butter. So we're gonna add in about 2 tablespoons. I'd like some vanilla as well, so I'm gonna add the vanilla extract into my milk. Makes it easier to mix. And of course, this is gonna be a little bit lumpier than usual because we have all of those mashed bananas inside. That's perfectly fine.
This is the consistency we're looking for. Not too thick, just dense enough to give us a nice, chewy pancake. I cook my pancakes, banana or any other kind, with some butter and a little bit of oil. Believe me, it'll make you happy.
What I'm gonna do is make silver dollar pancakes, or the really small pancakes. And for me, they don't have to be really round. Just wanna make sure they're nice and cute and they taste good, that's it. Keep it there, not move it, until you get little bubbles forming on top. That's the only time you turn them over. Last batch here. And what we have here is, because we didn't use the egg, the pancakes are actually less fluffy, and they gain a little bit of a chewy texture from the gluten from the bananas and also from the mixing, right? So what you're gonna get is a texture similar to the jambok that I had. So you get a little bit of gumminess between your teeth, but still a little bit sweet and very fragrant with the cinnamon and the banana in there. So this is gonna be really good. Let's plate this up. So I'm using a little bit of banana leaf here, just to remind people that we used bananas in them. And I'm gonna do short stacks. Maybe about 5. I want to cut through a little bit of that sweetness, that richness. And I have here local yogurt cheese that I cannot open the bottle to again. And I have here some local yogurt cheese. So it's almost like a very light cream cheese, but it tastes a lot like yogurt. So it's perfect. It's gonna be zesty and a perfect complement to the pancakes.
No yogurt cheese? Some cream cheese mixed with whipped cream would do just as well with these pancakes.
And just put that everywhere. Make it an abstract. Just a touch of mint right on top of each.
There it is, banana bread pancakes. Chew on that.